I first found out about my bicuspid aortic valve when I was in college. I was actually in a practice and I had a rapid heart rate, and our team trainer sent me to the doctor's office where I had an echocardiogram, which was the first echocardiogram I'd ever had in my life. And my doctor told me at the time that I really wouldn't have to worry about it, maybe until into my 70s or 80s, most likely never. After the season was over, I went down to the Mayo Clinic and did a battery of tests, and they found out that I had an aneurysm in my aorta, which was caused by my bicuspid aortic valve. I had surgery that April to get the problem fixed. They spared my valve because it was working so well, my native valve. 10 years later, as my valve deteriorated, I had to have a second surgery to replace the valve. And when you come to terms and you come to grips with what you're facing, and you talk to other people that had gone through it, and you get second opinions, and you need this surgery, then you have to start making the decision. What do I want to go with? Do I want to have additional surgeries? Do I want to go with a mechanical valve like the On-X that's going to require a blood thinner? The biggest thing that I thought about when my heart surgeon was talking to me about the different options of a tissue versus a mechanical valve, my biggest concern with the tissue is that I would have to have a third surgery, and that was a huge concern. After doing a lot of research, looking at tissue valves, looking at mechanical valves, I decided to go the mechanical route, and that's where the decision for me was very easy to go with the On-X valve, because I knew most likely that that would be the last open heart surgery that I would have to go through.